The state land department is proposing changes regarding jet ski operations at Keehi Lagoon, but it may also affect canoe paddlers. The public is invited to give input next week, but today Bridget Namata dug deeper and found out some paddlers are not pleased. Bridget?
Hi, Kathy. The Division of Boating and Ocean Recreation tells me it wants to relocate the jet ski area zone for safety purposes. But I found canoe paddlers who say it might be safer for jet ski operators, but not for them.
The Keehi Lagoon area is divided into zones for activities like canoe paddling, jet skiing, swimming, and boating. DLNR is thinking about moving the jet ski zone, currently near the reef runway, to an area between Kahaka Aulana Island and Mokawea Island. A spokesman says it would be a safer area for jet ski riders, but it brings jet skis closer to the designated canoe area. A paddler I spoke with says it's a bad idea.
How could these proposed changes possibly affect the canoe club?
I think it's the safety concern that we're more concerned about. I think we're a club with about 90 kids that practice out of here. And if we look to the water, it's just, if we have all these motorboats crossing by, you really can't see a little head popping out in and out the water, and then it becomes a boating problem.
Pacho showed us an example. People on jet skis zipping over to the designated canoe area.
That's illegal. Yeah, so there's actually signs posted up over there. It says no wake zone. There's a sign that's right over here. I think there's a big sign that says no wake zone. This whole stretch are no wake zones.
And they're doing it anyway.
Yeah.
So that on a daily basis?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's a daily basis of people are always ripping by.
For canoe paddlers, DLNR's proposed amendments to Keehi Lagoon presents a host of problems they plan on addressing at the upcoming public hearing.
They know our presence here. They know how many the numbers we have here. The 6 to 7 canoe clubs with 100 to 200 paddlers each. My main concern is our kids, our Keiki program.
I reached out to a few jet ski companies, but haven't gotten a response. The public hearing will be held at the UH Marine Education and Training Center on August 20th from 6 to 8 p.m. Check out our website, khon2.com, for more information. Bridget Namata, KHON2 News.